can subdue those that rose up against us. What do you say? Under the foot,
under me that rose against, under me that rose against me.
That's right. Every time somebody rise up against us, meaning want to bring harm to us, that curses us, that talk bad about us, to mock and scoff us. Guess what? The Lord always has our back and protects us. The Lord always kills that person or puts a fear of punishment on that person. See what I'm saying? Because they're speaking against the Lord's men. See what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Thou hast also given me the necks of mine enemies, that I might destroy them that hate me.
That's right. So the Lord has given us what? The necks of our enemies. Yes, we do have enemies here in America. We just read it out the Bible. See what I'm saying? This is not our word. We're reading out the Bible. Something that your pastor is not doing. So the Lord said he has given us the necks of our enemies, which means what? We get to choke the shit out of them. See what I'm saying? So when all hell breaks loose and fuck with that spirit on us, guess what? We're going to choke you till your head pop off. Till your head busts like a pimple. See what I'm saying? That the Lord giving us his power and might. The Lord said this. The Lord said he giving us the neck of our enemies, man. You know what that means? When the Lord give you the neck of your enemy, that means total destruction to your enemy. Who is our number one enemy? This white man. That's who. That's who got our people in poverty and suffering and don't know who they are. See what I'm saying? But the Lord said he's giving us the necks of our enemies. Does that sound like love? No, that sounds like hatred. See what I'm saying? He loved his children, Israel, but guess what? He hates you white people. Point blank, period. So the Lord didn't die on the cross for y'all. And that's the gospel, the good news to Israel, not to the whole world. Y'all gonna die. You gonna die. You gonna die. The Lord is going to kill y'all.
It said they cried, but there was none to save them.
Right.
Even unto the Lord, but he answered them not.
See? They cried to the Lord, help me, Jesus! Help me, Lord! But the Lord wasn't there. He didn't hear y'all. Meaning what? The Lord is not going to hear your cries. You're going to be destroyed. You're going to die. Especially you Negroes that think you got it good here in America, man. How the hell you got it good here in America? You got to beat up Rolls Royce, man. See what I'm saying? That's an oxymoron, man. They let you know this white man's society ain't about nothing, man. You spend all this money on a car and it's beat up and broke down, and that's supposed to be luxury. What sense does that make, man? You gotta spend all your money to fix up a vehicle? That's moronic.
He said, then did I beat them small as the dust before the wind. I said, then did I beat them small as the dust before the wind. I did cast them out as the dirt in the streets.
That's total annihilation, man. When he beat you into dust and then just blow.
You see that shit down there in
Yeah,
they shot them
beans and
turned
them
into dust.
Yeah, they did. And then the dust did blow into the wind like dirt. Oh, man. The Lord is awesome, man. A lot of y'all is going to learn about playing with the Lord, man. Y'all going to learn the hard way. Y'all going to get beat in the powder. But you're going to learn, though. You're going to learn today. Oh, man.
I'm joking with it, but you have a good time with the scriptures, but this is a very serious matter.
Right.
The Lord's coming back and he's going to put his vengeance down and his wrath down on all you crackers and you two-thirds dicks, man. Y'all going to learn, man.
That's right. give me Hosea 13 and 16.
Hosea chapter 13, verse 16. It says, Samaria shall become desolate, for she hath rebelled against her God, her family. And they shall fall by the sword. Their infants shall be dashed in pieces, and their women with child shall be ripped up.
Ain't that how y'all did our ancestors? You ripped our ancestors' children up in their belly? Well, the Lord said it's gonna happen to y'all. Samaria is synonymous with America. You get what I'm saying? So everything y'all did to us is gonna happen to y'all.
Matter of fact.
Stuff. That's right, I'm gonna finish up for now. That's the spirit. How you doing, bro? Who you with? You with yourself? So you teach yourself? What you teach? Hey, come park over here. Come on. Scared red. Yeah, I'm gonna get in your head. Come on, you teach yourself. Ain't no way in here you can teach yourself. Everybody has a teacher. We ain't just wake up one day and say we're gonna preach the Bible. We all got teachers. Get Revelation 18 and 6. We don't need no drive-by Israelites, man. Get out here and teach your people.
Revelation chapter 18, verse 6, it said, reward her even as she rewarded Judah.
Reward who? America. As she rewarded who? Israel, you Negro, Latino, and Native American. Go ahead, bro.
It said, and double unto her, double according to her works.
See? Reward her double. So everything she done to us, like we read in Hosea, how she ripped our children out of our ancestors' belly, we're going to do it to her. Triple fold.
Go ahead, bro. He said, and the cup which she had filled to her double.
That's right. Which is what? This slavery. This destruction, man. So everything that she done to us, guess what? It's going to turn around and go back to her.